Hey everyone, I've been waiting all weekend for the D23 special look footage for The Rise of Skywalker to be released, and finally this morning, our wait is over. I've seen it a few times at this point, so what I want to do is break it down and explain what we see, and I'm going to add a few of my own thoughts on what it could mean. I will say that these are my tempered opinions, with a bit of speculation, but no in-depth theories at this point. I'll note at the beginning here that the footage shown isn't a trailer or even a teaser, and is being referred to as a special look for Episode 9, The Rise of Skywalker. For this reason, the footage starts off by looking back at the previous 8 films, further promoting the idea that Episode 9 is the final culmination in the Skywalker saga. From A New Hope to The Empire Strikes Back to Return of the Jedi, we see all of the epic scenes of the original trilogy, beginning with Luke looking at the twin sons of Tatooine and ending with shots from the Battle of Endor. It then transitions into the same type of montage for the prequel and sequel trilogies, including the duel on Naboo, Anakin and Padme's wedding, the Clone War, the rise of Darth Vader, and the Battle of Crait. Clearly, the special look is making the point that everything has led to the events of Episode 9, serving as a bookend in the story of the Skywalkers. More importantly, we hear the voice of what I have to assume is Luke over these shots, stating, "We've passed on all we know, 1,000 generations are in you, but this is your fight." Based on the words alone, it sounds like Luke speaking to Rey, a passing of the torch so to speak. In this regard, I do hope we see more scenes of Luke in some way passing on this knowledge that came before her, as Episode 8 was a bit short on these aspects for what I was hoping to see. The time jump between Episode 8 and Episode 9 will hopefully allow for something like that to happen. But this setup and nostalgic view across the saga accounts for the first minute of the footage, leaving the final minute for new material from The Rise of Skywalker, the stuff we've been waiting all weekend for. So let's jump right into it. It opens with Rey, Poe, Finn, Chewbacca, and C-3PO on a planet that we've seen before, featured heavily in the teaser trailer released earlier this year at Star Wars Celebration. This, of course, isn't the planet Tatooine or Jakku, but a new planet called Passana, a desert planet we know is located on the edges of the galaxy. This time, there's no TIE silencer, but what appears to be a celebration being held by the local Aki Aki who make their home on Passana. After a very quick shot of Leia, we then get a number of Resistance or possibly New Republic starfighters come out of hyperspace, including X-Wings, A-Wings, Y-Wings, and B-Wings, and even a CR-90 Corellian Corvette. Immediately after that, we get my favorite shot of the special look. Although the Rey shot at the end is going to get the most focus in the coming days, I believe this is the most important and telling of the new scenes. We see a massive fleet of Star Destroyers, which instantly conjures images of the Eternal Fleet for anyone who's a fan of SWTOR. I'm confident in stating that these are Imperial-class Star Destroyers, specifically Imperial 1-class. This is an important distinction from the First Order Star Destroyers, and if we get a return of Palpatine and a connection where the Sith Troopers are part of a fleet and military led by the Dark Lord of the Sith, something like this is a perfect lead-in for that. Of course, as we know, during the Imperial era, Palpatine spent vast resources to set up storehouses, shipyards, and laboratories within the Unknown Regions. This fleet could be a separate force of Imperial loyalists that branched off from what would eventually rise to become the First Order, instead staying completely loyal to the Emperor, and using the resources in the Unknown Regions to create a completely separate armada. But if this was established in some way by Palpatine in preparation for his return, I would love to see something like that. I will say that this fleet appears to be totally unknown to the galaxy, as we see a shot with Finn and a new character named Janna appear to be shocked by it. After briefly seeing a shot of Darth C-3PO, we then have an interesting shot of what appears to be a super laser obliterating a planet, which has a surface defined by snow-covered mountains. The damage isn't akin to that done by Starkiller Base, but it's very similar to the scene in Rogue One with the destruction of Jeddah. Given that we know they utilize miniaturized Death Star tech, I wouldn't be surprised if this was the work of the First Order. We then see an extremely intense and focused Rey on what appears to be the forest moon of Endor based on the terrain, apparently training in lightsaber combat. This would be a great tie-in to the scene we saw in the Episode 9 teaser, where it's been greatly speculated we see the wreckage of the second Death Star on Endor, with Rey in that scene as well. The next shot with Kylo is another favorite of mine. We see Kylo ignite his lightsaber as he walks away from his TIE silencer, but the terrain and location is the real interesting part. Although it's possible for the fleet of Imperial Star Destroyers we previously looked at to be in a section of space like we saw in the film Solo, possibly the Maw itself or somewhere similar, it also seems like they're in the atmosphere of a planet that we now see Kylo Ren on, given the similar lightning strikes and cloudy blue hue. The complete desolation of the planet forces me to think of the possibilities where this is a location consumed by the dark side, something I would love to see in the film. There might be something similar here to the planet Zaos Anathema in Legends, where Palpatine is living off the life force of the planet itself to sustain him. But let's not get too far off track here. In a very similar shot seen within the poster released alongside this special look, we then see Kylo and Rey engaging each other in lightsaber combat on what appears to be the wreckage of the second Death Star if we continue our thinking from the teaser trailer. It's just a quick look at the duel, but it does seem to be a scene that's being heavily promoted at this point as well. And finally, we get the fastest shot possible of a hooded Rey in dark robes wielding a red double-bladed lightsaber. This, of course, will probably be the most talked about aspect to the footage, and rightly so, I think. But with so little context at this point, it's very hard to speculate on what exactly it means for Rey. The look itself is great, sharing aspects to Legend Sith like Darth Xana and the Fallen Bastila, but where Rey even is isn't all that clear. Perhaps it's a temple of some kind, but even that's hard to say. What we do have here though are the words of Palpatine himself over top of these final scenes, saying, "Your journey nears its end," which is then followed up with the epic sound of Darth Vader breathing. The combination of Palpatine and Vader is great at the end here, but I don't know if it draws a firm conclusion for Rey. If I had to guess, I'd say the Rey scene is more on the side of a vision, a look at a possible path for Rey, rather than confirmation that Rey falls to the dark side in Episode 9. Given what we've seen here, I'm more confident than ever that Palpatine will be the primary antagonist of the film. At least I hope so. But those are just some of my early thoughts and reactions to the D23 special look footage for Episode 9. I'm much more interested in hearing what you think, so please don't hesitate to let me know what your favorite moments were and what you think it could mean in the comments section below. Thank you for watching, everyone, and as always, may the Force be with you.